Hey everybody, I'm back to share with you guys my favorite winter time nail polishes. I ironically picked out 10 of my top favorite nail polishes plus one glitter, which I didn't really count because I kind of like, you know, it being 10. And I swatched it all for you guys, not on my nails, but the little fake nail ring color wheel that I bought from Sally's Beauty Supply, which will make it a lot easier to show you guys all these colors. The polishes themselves are in no particular order, so they're just, you know, all these colors that I like. And usually in the winter, I typically go for darker colors. Not, let's say, black, but more of a, you know, the taupey colors, or red for the holidays. I love red all the time because it's just a classic color for the nails, and red is my favorite color, rather than like bright greens and such. Showing you guys a mixture of brands. All the brands shown, I will link off all the stores that you can purchase them from in the box. Zoom in a bit so you're gonna be all up in my face just so you guys can see this a little bit better. So the first color is by China Glaze, and it's a really pretty dark purple, and it's called Cowgirl Up. They had like some sort of rodeo collection a long time ago. I don't really remember what it was called. I used to be so addicted to this nail polish when I first started wearing nail polishes a lot. When I first started YouTube, I wore this maybe like months and months straight. I still actually have a lot left in the bottle. It's a really pretty metallic purple. It has a really nice sheen to it. And this is what it looks like if you had it, you know, on my skin tone. It's a super pretty purple. It looks probably kind of bold on camera, but it's one of those like, oh my god, you have to see it in person to appreciate how beautiful it is. All these colors swatched on the colorwear are all two coats, no base coat, no top coat, just two coats, except for the last one, which I'll explain later, but this is just an accurate representation of the color, and I always prefer to put two coats. It keeps them lasting longer. The next color is by MAC, and it's one of the few MAC nail polishes I own. I really never try to go buy these. I typically receive them as gifts, but this is the only polish I actually bought myself. I really liked it when it came out with the Liberty of London collection, if I'm correct, and I picked this up when I picked up Peach Stock lipstick. It sold out pretty fast. It's called Blue India. This is what it looks like. It's a really pretty blue. It's so hard to explain it because it's like a muddy blue mixed with a little bit of green undertones, turquoise, just darker but not too dark. It's just really, really pretty. So if you can get your hands on this, I would recommend this. So the next color, I don't have the bottle next to me. I could not find it this morning, which sucks because I swatched this last night. But hopefully you guys don't mind too much. It's by Sonia Kashuk, and Sonia Kashuk can be found only at Target. It's the first nail polish of hers that I've tried, and it's pretty affordable. It's $5, $4.99, not too bad. And that's the color right there. As you can see, it looks nothing like Blue India, and it just looked a little bit lighter in the bottle than it really was. It's called Taunting Teal. It's not really teal at all. Again, it's like a dark blue mixed with some sort of turquoise, dark green. Because it really has strong green undertones if you concentrate really hard. But it's a pretty cool color that's not black, but still, you know, blue, wearable. The next color I really love for the holidays because it's just really pretty and really affordable. It's by Sinful Colors. This is what it looks like. And it's only 99 cents at Walgreens. And they last just as long as any other nail polish, which is really good, super affordable. It's really pretty. I definitely want to wear this for New Year's. It's a really nice, you know, party nail that's not too out there. It's not too overly shimmery, but it definitely has some glitters in it. The next color I'm actually wearing on my nails right now, so this is a pretty accurate swatch. I've worn it in a lot of my videos. I really, really like this. It's by Zoya, and it's called Colby. See? Super, super pretty. It's like a metallic, dark, ruby red. Woo! Cool, right? Very, very pretty, very appropriate for the holidays. I think I'm gonna wear this for Christmas. This color is by Essie, and it's called Stealing the Scene. This was also in one of my last nail favorite videos. It was my number one favorite color. This is still one of my favorites. I wouldn't say it's my number one because I think the Zoya polish takes that. But it's a unique silver that has like copper in it or something like that that gives it a really cool taupey copper feel to it, but still silver. This polish is also by Essie. It's called Very Cranberry. I've had this for a very long time. It looks a little bit redder on camera, but in person you have this like plummy red muted color. Really, really gorgeous, especially if you're not the type who likes fire red nails, but you still want some sort of red holiday effect. I'm a big fan of creams, as you can tell, so it looks really, really good. Next color is also by Essie, and it's called Chinchilla. And it's a cream that's like a muted gray. That's what Chinchilla looks like. It has like a nice purple undertone to it. Next color, everyone knows of it, and everyone knows there's like a million dupes for this color because every brand has been trying to make dupes for it so they can make a lot of money. Sephora by OPI, Metro Chic. Everyone knows this color. It's like everyone's favorite color ever, and there's plenty of dupes. Like I said, Sonia Kashuk has a dupe for it. Japanesque has a dupe for it. A lot of affordable things have dupes for it. But I bought this a long time ago, so I didn't go buy any dupes because I already have this. I never finished this bottle. But that was before everyone discovered the dupe, so boo-hoo for me. If you just look up anything about this, you'll find plenty of dupes about it. Just Google it. Very strong purple undertone, but still gray and taupey. That's what everyone loves about it. It's like a taupey purple gray. The next color is, again, by Essie, and it's a purple called Island Hopping, and it's a really cool cream purple. It's hard to explain this aside from it just being purple, and it feels like there's some sort of undertone of brown in it or gray in it. It's just really pretty. I find it a really unique purple, but it's not too like wham in your face. The last color is a glitter, and because it's the holiday times, everyone's into the glitters. Everyone's in love with the Sephora gold glitter polish, which I haven't gone to get yet just because I don't wear glitters that often. It looks really pretty though. It just looks a little thick, so I'm not sure about it. Eventually I might get it. This glitter I picked up at Ulta, but you can find it anywhere that OPI sells their new burlesque collection. I wore this polish on top of the gradient nail effect that gave it like a glitter effect that I was wearing in my perfect imperfection tag video. Extra Vaganza. Not like extravagant, but it's like extra VA Vaganza. I'll type it out right here. It's interesting. It has a bunch of copper and gold glitter reflects in it. It's just really pretty. So I wouldn't wear it personally by itself because it's just kind of like, glitter. So I topped it over the Zoya polish in Colby. It's the effect you get right there. And that's just one coat of the glitter on top of two coats of Colby. And it's really pretty if you just want to, you know, jazz up your nails. So those are all of my favorite winter polishes I had to show you guys. I hope you guys really liked it, and I hope all the swatches were really helpful. Thank you guys as always for watching. Please comment, rate, and subscribe, and I'll see you guys in a later video.